we take AI and forecast where floods are going to happen. We developed this flood hub, which is just a web page you can go to, and it takes our AI flood forecasting model and it shows you what that model says is happening over the next 7 days. Now we're working on the problem about how do we incorporate that, how do we use that in a way that supports governments in times of crisis. The geographic distribution of high quality data is non-uniform. AI can actually reduce that discrepancy. We can train a model that learns on all the global data, and it's able to learn general patterns of behavior. So for floods, it's general patterns of behavior between rainfall and what's happening on the ground in the rivers. We work with NGOs, we work with national governments, we work with various branches of the United Nations, specifically the World Meteorological Organization, and we develop programs that are designed to reach different types of communities. So all of our tools are all open and available. So if, let's say, a national hydromet agency wants to use the technology, the AI technologies that we've developed, this is possible. We'd like to be able to support that kind of activity across the range of, let's say, technical capacity of national governments. We really want to have the disaster warning owned by the government. They did a survey of 319 communities in Bihar, India, covering about 1.8 million people, and asked the question, what are the outcomes after a flood, depending on whether a village or a community got an alert versus didn't get an alert? Post-disaster medical costs at the individual level, the family level, was reduced by about 30%.